Public Affairs Broadcasting.
Special programming from Rockingham County Radio, rcrlive.com.
Good morning and welcome to Community Accents. I'm Dixie Penn, past president and current board member of the United Way of Rockingham County. And today I'm sitting in for Dr. Cindy Sorry, executive director of the United Way. And we have as our guest today Amy Nalley, who is the director of the Boys and Girls Club. Good morning, Amy.
Good morning, Dixie.
It's fun to be here. You know, I told you when I drove up, I'm in familiar territory. I was the director of the Madison Med-Ed Recreation Department for almost 30 years. And I don't know, when I didn't expect this. When I drove up, I've been here before. And when I drove up, all the, I guess they're your day camp? They were
yes,
out there.
Yes, our summer camp, yes.
And you were leading them. Maybe Simon Says?
That was it.
Oh, that was really, really neat. I love watching you. You're so good at that, Amy.
Well, I thoroughly enjoy being here at the Boys and Girls Club, and it's been an honor to step in this position. It's been a little over 8 years now, so it goes quick, and sometimes it seems slow, but it's just a great experience and a great organization.
Well, I'm used to seeing you in the executive position, and today I saw you in maybe a programmer position. And that's the one thing I think about what we do or what I used to do. But we have to do a little bit of all of it, don't we?
Oh, there's no doubt about it, especially being a smaller club. You know, yeah. Boys and Girls Clubs have over 4,000 nationwide. And some of them are huge in Chicago and Atlanta. And a lot of them are in the rural areas like we are. And our staff does every position that you can do, and I try to do every position. Yeah. It's all about getting to know the kids and making them feel, you know, that they belong and that this is their club, and, you know, it takes all of us to do that. Yeah. So it's fun.
Oh, it is fun. It has its challenges too, though, I know. But before we get started talking about Boys and Girls Club and United Way, Amy, tell us a little bit about yourself. I know you've already said you were here 8 years, but tell us more about yourself.
Well, I am a graduate of Clemson University, very proud Tiger fan, and I met my husband of, 33 years now we've been together.
Wow.
And have been in Eden about 20 years, and was with the Student Health Centers, which is also a United Way organization. I was
right.
with
I
them for 10 years.
That. So you
yeah.
were there before you came to Boys and Girls Club.
I was there before I came to the club, and my oldest daughter went to UNCG as well as my younger. I have two of them, one 29 and one 26, and they're just doing terrific, and they're over in Greensboro, and Eden just provided a great place for them to grow up and succeed, and it's just been great, and we've loved living here.
That's great, Amy. You know, I have to tell you, I was at Food Lion grocery shopping last week and ran into somebody that has recently joined the United Way Fund Distribution Committee, and he was telling how much he was enjoying his new experience, because he's a retiree in Madison. And he, I said, well, where are some of the places you went to observe? And he said, that Amy Nalley. He said, he was so impressed with you. And I think one of the reasons was because he said every child that walked through the door, you spoke to them with their first name.
You know, that's what is unique about this club. We get to concentrate totally on kids. And all our staff knows the kid's name, you know, and it's a matter of building character and have them have that sense of belonging like we talked about, yeah. and confidence, and let them know that this is their club, and, you know, to take pride in that and yeah. pride in themselves and help succeed. We concentrate really in three areas, and part of that was through the assessment that the United Way did, the community assessment, mm-hmm. and it's academic success for them to get promoted to the next grade level and to have a plan for the future when they graduate, mm-hmm. healthy lifestyles to increase exercise and you know, nutrition education, mm-hmm. and those kind of things, and then character and leadership development. And they've got to have that sense of confidence and everything to succeed in life, and that's our goal. And we do know every child's name, which is just great, and so the kids feel safe, and it's just a great place to come.
Amy, what are some of the programs and services the Boys and Girls Club offers, and how does United Way help in this?
Sure. As I said, those three main areas we concentrate on with the academic success, we're actually here in our computer lab, which I think is unique for after school. We have 10 computers for the kids, and they work on those, and those are supported by United Way. One of the programs that we do with that is called Net Smarts, and it's internet safety, not to give your name out, not to give your address, not to get on chat rooms, those kind of thing. That's supported by United Way, as well as our Power Hour program, where we use volunteers and our staff to help the kids get their homework done, to make sure that that's all taken care of. And people have been great on helping us with that, and that is also sponsored by United Way.
But, you know, the computers are becoming more and more vital as part of your programming, I know, in after school, because our church has a tutoring program. And we started, I guess, about 5 years ago, and one of the things that we suggested that the director have was computers. And she said, oh, we don't need computers. We're small. We got volunteers. We'll be fine. Well, last year she requested computers. She says, we can't do it. We cannot get them through. We can't teach them what they need to know without the computer. So it's great you've got this computer lab.
It really is that we have a great partnership with the Rockingham County school system, and a lot of the teachers actually have homework and have suggestions for the kids to learn on the computers. Science fair projects, you know, kids don't have that opportunity to have them at home sometimes, so they can type up their reports, and it's clean and it's nice. And so it gives them that opportunity, and again, just, you know, makes them feel better and proud of what they're doing.
One of the things that amazed me, I was talking with Mark Wells, this was several years ago, and he was visiting our computer lab, and he was showing me on the computer how you can actually do your music homework, that, you know, if you were taking piano or you were maybe some kind of music theory or whatever, all of this is on the computer. I had no idea. I thought it was just, I won't go into what I thought it was, but anyway.
Well, we've had theme weeks here this week, and so the kids come in, and you don't realize how important it is to find information. So during an hour each day, all the children get to come in, and so they looked up things like on the barrier reef, and they said, you know, the barrier reef is really an animal, not a plant, and you know how big it is, and it's all off Australia. So great learning tool, and again, I think it's unique to have 10 like we have here, and it's just a great system.
Okay, we've talked about the computer lab, but tell me, you know, kind of quickly, all the programs you offer. I know you have sports programs because we have played with you in tournaments and things. Just kind of give us a run through of some of your programs.
Sure. We talked about the academics. We have the Power Hour program and the computer labs. Our healthy lifestyles, we do have the organized sports, which United Way helps support, which is football, baseball, cheerleading, softball, and basketball.
So you have football. Do you
play
in the county league?
We do not play in the county. We play with the recreation department. We play with Reedsville. We play with Fieldale, and we play among ourselves.
Oh, very good. So Reedsville didn't join the county, did they? So
no.
Well, that's good.
No,
that's
no.
Great.
That league has been established, you know.
Yeah.
The club, we're getting ready to celebrate our 60th anniversary, and we have pictures from 1955 where these guys were playing football down here in this league. So it's been here a long time, and we play there among us. With the healthy lifestyles, we do a lot of things like with the Kate B. Reynolds Trust. We just got some funding from that. So we have smart walls on the wall. We have new equipment. I mean, it's just amazing what we've been able to do. We're doing cooking classes now with the kids. They just made basil scrambled eggs, and we've got the basil from our garden. We have a horticulture garden here, and the tomatoes and things like that. And then we have Smart Moves and Street Smarts, which is peer relationships and getting along with others, and drug and alcohol prevention, gang prevention programs. So it amazed me when I started 8 years ago, and when we have a Youth of the Month and Youth of the Year also. But
you know, it's funny you say that, because when I was outside, when I arrived, and I was seeing the children leave the area out there where you were doing the program, one little girl had on a T-shirt that said Youth of the Month, and I thought, is she the Youth of the Month? So.
She has been.
Oh,
and
great.
So each of them get a shirt, and, you know, they wear it very proudly, and it's that character building again. So like I said, when I came here, I thought, it's kids playing around and all, and I had no idea what Boys and Girls Clubs do, and it's just amazing. Denzel Washington is probably one of the biggest spokesmen.
Oh, I love him.
And LeBron James and Jennifer Lopez. Mm-hmm. I mean, it goes on. The Bushes. It's amazing all the people that have come from clubs and what they've taught them. So, and even locally, Reese Pirtle is still on our board. Neville Hall's on our board. I can't say much about my board of director, Boyd Higgs.
I'm impressed with your board. I already am familiar with your board. You have a very good one.
So. A great board, yes. So it's just, and a lot of them have succeeded from coming through here.
Right.
So,
Amy, I think we take for granted sometimes that people know who we are, where we are, and all about us. But for those that don't know where you are, because I didn't yesterday, I mean, I've been here lots of times, but I always have somebody either driving in front of me or I'm riding in their car. Tell us where you're located. And do you have to be a member to participate in programs, and what's the cost?
Sure. It is amazing, like I said, being here so long that people don't really realize that the club is here, but I think that's changing. If you know Dick's Drive-In in Washington Street, we're basically right behind Dick's Drive-In at 1026 Harris Street. It's just one block back. You can take Reynolds or West or whatever, and you'll run into us.
Well, I came that way today, and I've never been that way. And you were right. You turn right past Dick's Drive-In if you're going to Eden, and you run right into the Boys and Girls Club.
You can't
Club.
Miss it.
But before, I've come, I guess, some indirect way. I don't know, but it was all, it was not that easy. But anyway, we're talking with Amy Nalley today, who is the director of the Boys and Girls Club, and we're telling you where it is and about being a member. Can you tell us about that?
Sure. We do have a membership. You do need to be a member to come in, and that's for a lot of different reasons. Our membership is $40 for the year.
Wow. And you don't pay any other dues?
The summer camp, because we're open from 7:15 in the morning to 5:30, and is an additional $260. So if you come from 7:30 to 5:30 in the summer, and then after school from 2:30 until we're open until 8 o'clock at night, it is $40. It's $300 total, but the kids that come just during the school year, it's $40.
That's fantastic. And I had no idea.
We want to make sure that every kid has the opportunity to come. We have never turned a child down.
Do you give scholarships?
We do give scholarships,
and
some of those are through the United Way also. Mm-hmm. That's part of one of the programs they support. So just a great place. We have about 402 members, and about 150 come every single day after school.
Wow.
So it's pretty exciting. So we do require you a member. If you're playing that organized sports, is the only extra fee there is, that's a $10 fee for each sport that you play, and that helps with the refs and the uniforms and things like that and the lights. So it's easy. You can look at our website, www.bgceden.com, Boys Girls Club Eden. Everything is tied to that. Or contact me at bgceden@triad.rr.com and get some information on our programs.
I want to ask you about your website.
Yes.
I went yesterday and I couldn't find it. And I put in Boys and Girls Club of Rockingham County. Was that the wrong? Because it came up with some other state.
Right. So, it is the Boys and Girls Club of Eden.
Okay.
Not of Rockingham
Boys and Girls
County.
Club of Eden.
Although, please know that we serve many kids. A lot of these kids we serve, especially here in the summer. They're from Stoneville. They're from Madison. Their parents work here in Eden.
That's
great. It started out at the Leakesville Boys Club, the Boys Club of Leakesville, the Leakesville Police Boys Club. That's how it started in 1955, because those original guys knew that kids needed a safe place to learn and to grow and to make long-lasting friendships. So it became the Boys and Girls Club of Eden. But we do serve all of Rockingham County and even Ridgeway. There's no restriction at all on becoming a member. You don't have to live in Eden or anything. So we serve all the zip codes here in the county.
We're talking with Amy Nalley today, who is the executive director of the Boys and Girls Club of Eden.
Yes.
And Amy, what about your hours of operation? I know it's probably different in the summer than during the school year, but give us both of those. And do you have transportation from school here for the children?
Sure. We are open during the school year as soon as the kids get out, 2:30 until 8. And then we're here for teacher work days and those kind of things, and holidays and Christmas, you know, except
yeah,
for the basics.
I was wondering about that. So you are open
So that's
on
all
holidays.
Included in that $40. Okay. So we're open all those days. And transportation, I think, with any organization is somewhat of an issue.
Oh, it really is. Do you have the buses bring the children here?
Yes, we're very lucky with the school system. It was just established a long time ago. Any school within this district, they will bring them. So we get kids from Douglas on the school buses for free, from Leakesville Spray, mm-hmm. from Holmes and Moorhead. And then we have started a van, which we charge a small fee for, to Central, because we had such a great need. Mm-hmm. And we are looking for another van or another type of transportation. We have our 15-passenger van, but we have a waiting list for mm-hmm. 14 more kids. So we want to run two vans and totally understand the school mm-hmm. system and having to do it, but within this area. So,
you know, that's the problem.
Anybody got any ideas on that? Please feel free to.
Yeah, Amy needs
give
a
me
van,
a call.
So,
yes.
If you want to donate one, or you want to help her get one,
or
call Amy
transport
Nalley.
The kids.
That's
would be
right.
wonderful.
That transportation is such a big in our tutoring program at the Madison Presbyterian Church. We have the transportation problem. So so I understand. Amy, what is a typical day at the Boys and Girls Club? And I know we've talked summer is different than the school year, but let's talk about the school year, because that's
sure.
what you do the most. And I know, seeing all these computers here, that probably homework is a big thing, but
sure.
what is typical from the time they get here until they go home?
Sure. Well, like I said, 2:30, the kids come in. We have them spread out throughout, because we have so many kids we're helping with homework. So they're in our teen room, they're in our front, and they're here. And then the staff is going around and helping do that. The kids that don't have homework go to the gym with Cam Dillard, who we recently hired. He's our health and fitness director now. So that's just wonderful to have that full-time position. And he does an organized activity, whether it be kickball, whether it be the smart walls, whether it be relays, whether it be the Presidential Fitness Awards, mm-hmm. Those kind of things. And then the middle school comes in and the high school come in at 3:30. And so these guys, power hour, that's why mm-hmm. it's called that. Then they have their opportunity to do that and get their homework done and all. And then we will run certain days our smart moves classes, our street smarts classes, some arts and crafts, whatever, in the teen room. But a lot of it is, you know, they do have free time. We have the unbelievable playground, which was partly funded by the Reedsville Area Foundation.
I saw that. It's really a nice playground.
It's great. It's great. We have the athletic fields out there. We have the baseball. So a child will come in. They'll get their homework done. They'll go get a snack and maybe a drink. They'll mm-hmm. hang out with their friends. They'll go into the smart moves class and talk about peer relationships. They'll come back out, shoot a game of pool, go outside and play and make those long-lasting relationships. And, you know, they might have football practice right mm-hmm. after that, starting at 5:30, or might have a game. And then they hang out, and parents get them when they can.
The Boys and Girls Club is definitely a big part of these kids' lives.
It's their childhood.
Yeah,
it is their childhood in many cases.
And they will never forget it. And thank you for what you do, Amy. You do such a good job. We're talking with Amy Nalley this morning, who is the executive director of the Boys and Girls Club of Eden. What has been your greatest experience as the director of Boys and Girls Club?
You know, we had a Community Heroes Week, and we had several alumni come in, and they were saying, you know, one of their best experiences was making that long-lasting lifetime friend. And, you know, where I'm not necessarily, I'm more of a parent role here. As these kids grow up, and like I said, 8 years, to see them develop from 6 years old, which is the ages they can start, 6 to 18 is the ages that they're allowed to come. They can play sports at 4, but to come every day, you have to be 6. And when I first got here, you know, Terry Vernon, terrific, and Sam mm-hmm. Law, terrific. That's why this place has succeeded in the past. And they weren't quite sure what a new director yeah. was going to be, especially a woman coming in. And a few of them have grown up and graduated and gone on to college. And when they were getting ready to leave and finish, and they'd come in and say, you know, Miss Amy, I really appreciate what you did. I understand why you told me no on mm-hmm. this or that. And to seeing them grow up and succeed is definitely what brings you back every day.
You know, I, and again, I can relate to what you're saying, since I have been in a similar position as recreation director of Madison Med Inn, and I love it when I go to Food Line and this person walks up and says, "I know you don't remember me, but Miss Dixie, you know."
Yeah, yeah.
And it thrills me to death that they actually know me, you know. So so I know I can relate to all that, and so it's, I guess we are the ones that are blessed to have those kinds of jobs. But Amy, where do you see the most critical need for the Boys and Girls Club?
You know, funding is always an issue. We were very lucky with that Kate B. Reynolds Trust and to enhance that healthy lifestyles. And United Way has been a supporter for almost as long as we've been here, 59 years, and been a huge part of making sure that these doors stay open. I think we have wonderful programs. There's always room for improvement and to enhance those. You know, time is always an issue. So critical need for us really is funding.
I knew you were going to say that.
Funding always, and space.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and we run
staff,
out of space.
I know you need people to help you.
And so, volunteers, exactly. Yeah. So, yeah, those are definitely the needs here. And a van.
Don't forget about the van. She really needs a van. So you can donate a van, or you can give her money for a van, or you can just come talk to Amy and see what you can do to help her. United Way has been very fortunate to have a company to invest high dollars in Rockingham County, and that is what Williams Gas Pipeline does. Let's talk about their special golf tournament coming up in October. And, I don't know how familiar you are with this, Amy.
Great tournament.
It is, isn't it?
Yes.
I think the greatest thing about this tournament is that these people want to double your dollars. And, you know, just this week, I'm in the Madison Med Inn Rotary Club. Are you in a Rotary Club?
I am actually in the Lions Club here.
Oh, okay. So you're in a civic club. Anyway, we have got the United Way in our budget. And so we were talking, how can we double those dollars? So we were moving money around, and we got it. So we're going to get them a lot more money, get the United Way more money this year, because we will present our check to Williams Pipeline in October. And I want to see exactly when that is, because I had to talk to Madonna this morning and get, as we know, Sheriff Sam Page couldn't be here today. So we had to change the program around a little bit. But October 2nd at Monroton Golf Course in Reidsville will be the Williams Gas Pipeline Golf Tournament. And so anyway, we want to bring in as much money as we can on that day. And all you have to do is bring your money that day, and they will double it. So, you know, they've come close to $100,000 for us.
Yeah.
All because they doubled the money. And I want to give credit to Walter Romine. I know you.
Great
know, everybody
guy. Yes.
knows Walter. Everybody knows Calvin. They worked so hard on this golf tournament. And you would think they were in the recreation business, wouldn't you? Because they really, they know their stuff. But the one thing that is required for this golf tournament, you have to go in person to take your money. So, you know, we're taking it as Rotarians. We take it from the recreation department. I'm sure, Amy, you've been over there with yours. So remember that event. It is October the 2nd, the golf tournament that's going to double the dollars for the United Way of Rockingham County. I wanted to ask you, are there any special events or programs for the Boys and Girls Club coming up that you would like to highlight?
Well, sure. We do our annual golf tournament as a fundraiser in our reverse drawing. One thing we're really working on right now with our board is our getting our alumni, and getting, especially with the 60th year anniversary coming up. We have an alumni event. We were trying to do it in October, and it ended up with State paying Carolina on the date we wanted to do it, and the football and those kind of things. So we have set that event tentatively for August 5th, you can register at our website. Remember, Boys Girls Club Eden, bgceden.com, and there's a place there to register an alumni. Call me here at the club at 627-7960. Call a board member. We're trying to gather everybody's information now, and this is going to be a huge, we're doing a big pig picking and having the kids do some things and getting these guys a chance to come back and meet, because the stories you hear when you're just out are just amazing of what has happened here at the club. So from 1955 until today, we want everybody just to participate in this. Get us your information, and we're looking at somewhere around August 5th for that, and just can't wait. So,
you know, we take so much for granted. I guess we're doing our work every day, and we're so into it. We forget about those people that once were a part of what we are a part of now. We experienced this in our Rotary Club. We had alumni kind of thing, people past Rotarians. We invited them to one of our events. Mm-hmm. And the people that came said, this is so much fun because we miss it so much. We can't be a member now, but that's what's going to happen with your Boys and Girls
That's club, exactly right, and we want to continue and do this every year and have them have that chance to get to give back. You know, we were there for them then, and we need them now here to help and make an impact on these kids. So,
if you don't get a van before then, I'll bet you get a van on August
5th. That would be wonderful.
Because they will understand when
and
you tell
them.
And
it's not just about getting them to donate or anything by any means. This is, you know, this is what these clubs are about, is building those relationships.
Right.
And we want to make sure that continues.
You know, Amy, I think it's great how the different youth organizations work together in the county. And I'm talking about recreation, YMCAs, Boys and Girls Club. Can you talk about this a little bit, about the things that y'all do together?
Well, I tell you, there's no way to succeed without partners.
Yeah.
We play our organized sports together. We have meetings and we with the Reedsville Maidan and it's just a partnership, especially with the City of Eden and with Johnny Farmer and Terry being part of a past, you know, being here in the past. So anything that we can do for each other, we try to do.
And, you know, I don't
even though we're separate organizations,
right, and
the
I
partnerships
don't think people
are,
understand how we are in the same business, y'all or whatever, and that you do enjoy working together. I remember, and this was years ago, but Joey Connors, I don't know if you ever knew him.
Oh, yeah.
He was Eden Recreation Director, and Johnny took his place. And then Harry Brown, who was Reedsville Parks and Rec Director. And we got together. We used to get together on a regular basis just to talk about, you know, our jobs that we had in common, and that's really how Senior Games started. I know you're familiar with Senior Games, which is done all over Rockingham County, but it was from the recreation directors coming together and working together, partnering, like you were saying. So, and then I know the tournament that we have, that big basketball tournament.
Baseball, basketball, we have one, the Midget Bowl, so it's all of those. It's all, in all the sports.
Do you know,
great.
Amy, we are just about out of time. And I can speak from experience as director of the Madison Maidan Recreation Department for over 25 years. United Way makes a difference. I can see it from both sides, as an agency receiving money and as a volunteer raising money. We hope you will make a donation this year because every dollar counts. To sum it up, this is how it all comes through, helping people like the Boys and Girls Club. So would like to thank you, Amy, from the Boys and Girls Club, for joining me today to talk about United Way of Rockingham County. I'd also like to thank you and our listening audience for tuning in today. Remember, Dr. Cindy Sari will be back with you next month to talk about United Way of Rockingham County.
Thank you very much. Pleasure to be here.